Today I will show you the new panorama possibilities with Photoshop 2018. We load a 2D panorama with a sky hole, and then we go into the 3D method. We can change the focal length to have a little bit more view, and then we change the position to the sky where we can see the hole. Now Photoshop has an intelligent fill method. To use that, we have to first select the hole. And then we apply the intelligent fill method. That works very well if you have a cloudy sky. I will show you later with an Inspire panorama how we can fill the sky if it's only blue without any clouds. As you can see, it works pretty perfect. Now we can use some tools in this new 3D mode to finally adjust the image. If you have still some prop artifacts, we can delete them. So we can move to the region where we have to make a correction, and you can see not every tool is working in this 3D method. So what's working perfect is the stamping tool. With the stamping tool we can also eliminate artifacts from the props. The advantage of this new 3D method is really that we can search all the sky for final adjustment. It's very easy and quite fast to do that. If you have done all the corrections, we can adjust the focal length to have a similar view like on Facebook later, to have the same view. Now I will show you how we can add text on this panorama. It's in the nadir region. I like to add some text. Adding text is quite simple, like in the 2D method, but there's something special with the layer we just created. In the 3D mode, you have to be aware that it is not connected to the background image. So if you will move the background image, the text will stay on the same position. So we have to merge the layer to align it with the background image. The merging tool you cannot find on the layer image. You have to go to the layer menu. There you have a entry for merging the layers. If you have finished our 3D picture, we have to save it with a special method in the 3D menu. You can see it, panorama save. And we can just save the final image. This is a final view of this panorama. So the sky hole is filled and we have added text in the nadir region. Now let's see the full power of the Photoshop 2018 with an Inspire X5 25mm panorama. I've chosen a 30,000 pixels per line, so we can just fill the hole with the intelligent fill method, but that will give us some artifacts in the zenith region, but we will correct that later into the 3D mode. One thing, it's important if you have big images, do first the work in 2D mode. The 3D mode is very slow if you work with big pictures. So let's change to the 3D mode to see what we have done with the zenith. If we go up, we can see a 360-degree artifact and we can now correct that. It's the same as the picture before. Not all tools are working in this 3D mode, so the healing tool is not working. It would be the best to eliminate that very quick, but as you can see, nothing work here. So we have to do it with the stamping tool. we choose a quite a big radius, and so we can eliminate this line in the zenith region. The new 3D mode for panoramas in Photoshop helps us very quick to make full 360 degree panoramas. It's very easy to go to the region where we have to correct. With this new method, it's really easy to make perfect images. One thing about the sharpness in the 3D mode, you will see that it's a little bit blurred. It's not the same resolution as in 2D mode, but to correct pictures, it works quite well. I am working on a Retina display, so I can easily see the difference between 2D and 3D mode. I've already tested it on some panoramas and I'm quite impressed about this new method in Photoshop to work the panoramas. I will just correct this lens flare artifact from the sun, and then we go back to the full view size to see how we can work with filters. If we like to correct some colors on the picture, not every tool is working, but many of the filters are still working. If we work with filters, we have to copy the layer. With this method, we can always go back to the original image color, and we can see the difference online with the filtered image. I use a lot the high pass filter to sharpen the images, but I will not use it at 100%. But we can see the difference in this video if we compare it to the two images. If we use filters on big image sizes, it takes always a little bit time before the Photoshop has finished. Now we are finished and we can compare to the original image. Now I will downsize the filter effect. I use about 60%. And one important thing, it's like before, this new layer is not connected to the background image. So we have to merge them to connect the two layers. I will now save the image to a 2D image and I will reload this 2D image to rework some colors. It's not possible to do all this in 3D mode, so we can finally correct in 2D mode. If you like to do some tone mapping, for example, you can only do that in 2D mode. Now let's have a look on the final image. Everything seems correct. It's a nice hue on the autumn trees with these yellow colors. I hope you enjoyed this video. Until the next time, thank you for watching.